So here we are on March 28th, lazy day, didn't get going this morning on fishing at least. I was working on other stuff and didn't even start fishing until about 12:30, but conditions look good. I'm very close to home. As you can see, Mount Serenity is proudly displayed. And did do a little work on my fishing gear before I came out, but I have just been floating around, so happy at not just one but now two steelhead this year in my backyard. That second short video of the leaper was another fish that took one of my steelhead blades in my own home riffle and got me very excited. And then when I was redoing this Colorado rig, I went ahead and put on a white version of my float, in part because it was just sitting there, but also because I wanted to see if visually it shows up better on the camera, because it should be clear to everyone right now how excited I get about a really good bobber down. And this thing, at least to my eyesight, has better visibility than the green one or the gray one. Wow, it's deep out there right now. There we go. Get that little lean going. And but yeah, it's just been already, as of the end of March, it's just been a fantastic run for me. I'm not one that gets hung up on counting the number of steelhead I've caught, but just looking back at my own video journal, I know it's over 30, and like I said, it's only the 28th of March, so if anyone had told me when I hooked that first early fish, actually right in this water up here in November, that I would have lucked into 30 or so steelhead by the end of March, I would have said, I'm all in. And it's really been fun to catch them on these creations that I've either modified or completely made up out of the blue. But right now, and it's kind of, I guess, at the beginning of the run, kind of what I expected, but I basically have limited it now to three setups that I've caught all of those steelhead on. One, of course, my old go-to, which was a jig under a float. My newer go-to, I have to say, is probably a tie between a steelhead blade under a float or swinging spoons. Both I had experience doing before, but I've really emphasized them during this fishing this run, and they have just equally produced to the point where, and that's why I kind of hesitated, to the point where they're really my go-to now. I definitely still bring my jig materials, and I have a rig on my back right now set up to dead drift one of my own jigs through here. But depending on the water, it really has gotten to a point where my go-to rigs are hardware. And I like that, because those have always been favorite ways of mine to fish. But the stream back in Washington where I caught so many steelhead, it was basically a jig and float show, and I didn't even carry anything else. And so this river has opened my mind back up to those things that I used to tinker with, but now are becoming part of my main my main deal. Oh, gotta catch up. Oh, there we go. Another leaper. All right. Fish home in my close to home water. Ooh, that was so freaking cool. Please tell me I get to play with the film on that. That was an awesome leap. Spit the hook. Hook came flying back in my face. And believe it or not, I'm not standing here disappointed in that at all. I got by far the coolest part of that whole deal. Oh man, that was awesome. So, of course, when that happens, the first thing I always check is the hook, and it is good and razor sharp. It did not get dulled in any sense. This is one of those number four brass blades that I silverized, and in this bright light, you can still make out the hints of brass in there, because my intention is not to like make them look like store-bought silver plate. I call them white gold instead, but this has continued to be a hot one for me. And like I said, I testing out the white float, because for an old guy the visibility is really good. Can't even remember where I got these, but I only have a couple of them. But yeah, that is just as cool as it gets right there. And like I've said before, the take that you get on this setup, it can be so violent, and that one was. It was like I was kind of looking at my float. I mean, I had my attention out there in the general vicinity of my float, but that float was gone so deep, so fast, that I couldn't even see it under the water, even with that bright white and fluorescent orange paint on it. It was gone to the depths. There is nothing quite like spring steelheading. I didn't turn the camera on for it, but we just survived another very heavy snow flurry, or even if it's snow, it's more like sleet at this point. But I've got my layers on. I'm perfectly comfortable, but it is just part of the game that you know you're going to get the wild weather in the springtime. Well, on my way back down with the jig, there was something over there in that flat, but I'm thinking it's just going to be a nice cutthroat. I could be mistaken. Yeah, it's just a cutthroat. Ooh, coolly, a very cool colored up. Oh, I think it's a bull trout. Nope, it's a cutty with some very cool colors that'll be cool to look at. Look at how thick this guy is. Holy cow. Look at those colors on the cutthroat. Man. Most of these guys are at their point of going up their tributary streams or higher up in the system. Oh shit. All right. There he goes. Yeah, this year in particular, with the slightly warmer temperatures, a lot of the fish are already on their spawning runs. So I haven't been catching nearly as many cutthroat, but glad I got that one.